Hello my friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. In this video time lapse, I want to show you a little quick and kind of whimsical painting that's inspired by this famous masterpiece, The Birth of Venus. And let me see if I can pronounce the master's Italian name properly with an Italian accent. So let me do it. Sandro Botticelli. Well, okay, I'm not sure if I'm doing it right, but so this is, you know, as you can see, it's clearly inspired by this masterpiece, Birth of Venus by Sandro Botticelli. And I, you know, it's not, my painting is obviously much smaller, and, you know, it's kind of painted a la prima instead of using many, many layers of paint. And it's just a fun little take on this masterpiece. It's actually one of my homework pieces for this collaborative online art class, art course called Let's Face It 2018. And this collaborative art course this year basically is taking us through many of the major art movements throughout history, and you know, and study the major artists. Some are more well known, some are less known, those artists throughout all these art movements, throughout art history, and we study some of their pieces and then make a piece of our own painting that's inspired by them. And sometimes the piece that we make are actually, we study the techniques and try to employ the techniques. And sometimes, like for instance in my case, it's actually that I feel inspired by the feelings of this piece, and I just basically, instead of painting in the techniques of employing the technique of Botticelli, I am actually just have fun. So the lovely thing about this course is that you can choose to study the techniques, or you can simply just have fun and interpret it in a new way, like I do here. So my painting is also like painted quote-unquote a la prima, meaning I finished the painting in one session in probably like 2 hours or so. And and also because, as you know, Venus was born out of the sea, and there are kind of a couple of myths about the birth of Venus. And in one of the stories, actually let's begin with Uranus, which is the primal force or the primal god of the sky, and then the goddess Gaia as the earth. So they gave birth to some titans, and Uranus was afraid that they are gonna, his children are gonna overtake him, so he buried his children deep inside the earth, deep in the earth, and that caused the mother great pain. So the mother then asked Cronos, one of their sons, to help her, and gave her a sickle, which then Cronos used to cut off Uranus' genitals. It's a little bit brutal, I know. So cut off his genitals and threw them into the sea. So where the genitals were thrown into the sea, there were foams, you know, forming in the ocean, and then out of the foams born our Venus, the god of love. So that's one story of the origin of Venus, also known as Aphrodite by the Greeks. And so that's why in this painting I choose a cool palette, ocean blues and purples to represent her origins, which is the ocean, the sea. And the color palette that I'm using here is actually quite simple, basically just shades of blues, a warm blue, a cool blue, and purple. And I think the purple that I used is that oxygen purple. I've used some other purples before, but I really didn't like them. But I really love the dioxazine purple, which is a transparent, vibrant purple color, and you can, but you don't have to use purple if you don't have it. You can actually just mix your blue and like alizarin crimson or quinacridone red, like a cool red. But I really just like using purple here, which is like a shortcut. And as this is a pretty cool palette, so I've also used alizarin crimson or quinacridone red, so like a cool red. And just for fun, I added some flying fish, three flying fish to this painting. And the flying fish actually remind me of one of my favorite novel. I think probably you have read it too, The Life of Pi, where the boy survived a shipwreck and was trapped in a little boat with a tiger and some other animals, and they were basically starving. And then the flying fish came, flying over the boat, and basically saved his life and the life of the tiger Richard. So flying fish, in terms of symbolism, symbolized emotional freedom and being uninhabited. And I think in the case of, for my personal meaning, I think they also is a symbol of blessings. And just probably from this novel, The Life of Pi, that I read, they kind of life-saving, they symbolize freedom and also a blessing and happiness and joy. So I really just feel like incorporating them into this quick little fun painting of Venus. I hope you enjoy this little time lapse. And if you like my video and you find it interesting, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. And I will see you in the next one. Bye!